So we can say after the research that austerity measures implied by the Ukrainian government in response to the crisis of 2014, they disproportionately impacted women in Ukraine, especially women of underprivileged groups like rural women, single mothers, older women, LGBT women, ethnic minority women, and so on. And the most impact was in three realms. First of all, it was cuts for social expenditures, which mean that women were losing jobs in healthcare, in education, where predominantly female workforce is employed. On the other hand, this led to a shortage of infrastructure, which available for women in their reproductive labor, in taking care for children, for people with disabilities, and so on. And the third sphere in which women were impacted disproportionately is related to devaluation of their reproductive labor. So in all the social payments available for women with children, for single mothers, for women who are mostly women taking care of people with disabilities, all these social payments, they devaluated greatly, almost all of them. So these are three realms which made the impact of the austerity measures disproportionately harder for women in Ukraine. Well, first of all, we should criticize the general concept of austerity, which our government present as a kind of neutral, technical solutions to combat the crisis, which are definitely not, because they impact the underprivileged groups more than other groups, and including women. Secondly, we should somehow press the government to deal with the immediate outcomes of these reforms and their impact on women. And I think that the most urgent action should be taken in increasing the legal subsistence minimum, which devalued greatly. And this subsistence minimum, it influences most of the social payments. And so it's directly related to devaluation of women reproductive labor. Another thing should be related to the problem of unemployed women who lost their jobs because of the expenditure cuts in medicine, in healthcare, in education, in social workers, institutions, and so on. So there should be some problems for them to find another job and to deal, to have a kind of income they need for their life. While this problem theoretically exists in Ukraine, but we all know that they are quite problematic, and I believe they can hardly deal with the emerging problem of women unemployment. One of the most urgent actions should be taken in relation to payment during maternity leaves, because maternity leaves in Ukraine, they are totally unpaid. So women usually women stay at home for, I don't know, 2-3 years, depending on their circumstances, and they have no wage-related income at all. So while it is officially legal for a man to take this leave to take care for a child, but only 1% of Ukrainian of these leaves are taken by Ukrainian men, and definitely because this leave is not paid. So when a family is facing a problem, facing a choice whose salary they will lose because of the caretaking, they usually, it's women who have to leave their job because they earn less usually. And on the other hand, there are some conservative stereotypes about the role of women in reproductive labor. So this maternity leave should be somehow paid, and it should also be supported by the infrastructure, like the kindergartens should be developed more, because now only a little bit more than half of the children are covered by kindergartens, and in villages this problem should be even bigger. And also the government should do some measures to and feminists should pay attention to big underprivileged groups of women who suffer the most from the austerity measures. And these are, according to our research, like elder women, single mothers, women with children in general and women who live in rural areas and internally displaced women. It was different in different years, between something like 30% in the beginning of 2000s and 22% in 2012, I think. And what is also interesting that during this crisis, this difference, this gender pay gap, it increased. Partially because of the crisis itself, of course, but also because, I think, because of the austerity measures of the government. So the policy which government implied during the crisis, it was damaging women wages compared to men wages. The problem with examples is that basically, as for now, there was until now not a single, almost none attempts to evaluate the impact of austerity measures on women from leftist feminist perspective. Though there was the shadow report by Women League for Peace and Freedom, presented for UN Commission, but that was all, and no further systematic attempts were done. So basically this in the public image, in the mainstream especially, this link between austerity measures and position of women, this link is totally absent. Like, people just don't understand that this austerity measures impact women negatively. So there were not a single explicitly feminist protest in this respect. There was only one statement by one NGO, a big NGO, concerning excluding of 12,000 social workers from the state budget in 2014. And that was all I can find, like, in relation to austerity measures. Of course, there are some protests and campaigning of leftists, for example, against the new project of labor code. There were protests, also some quite known protest against cutting expenditure on education and so on. But these protests, they were quite separate. These were scattered protests. And no general campaigning against austerity measure ever existed in Ukraine, and especially with the emphasis on their impact on women.